Hi students, today's class is Hodgkin's disease part 1. Hodgkin's disease is a lymphoma characterized by the presence of large abnormal cells in a background of reactive appearing lymphocytes, macrophages, granulocytes and fibroblasts. This is a microscopic picture of Hodgkin's disease. Incidence. Hodgkin's disease is about twice as common in males than females. Shows two peaks of incidence, one in young adults and the other in the elderly. Pathogenesis. Chromosomal abnormalities have been detected in the majority of cases studied. Etiology. The etiology of Hodgkin's disease also remains unknown. The presence of significantly raised antibody titers to the Epstein-Barr virus in some patients has shown that there is a strong association between the virus and Hodgkin's disease. Epstein-Barr virus is also found in a number of other malignancies, both lymphoid and non-lymphoid, which suggests that Epstein-Barr virus infection cannot be specific for Hodgkin's disease. Clinical features. Hodgkin's disease occurs in three distinct forms. First one, seen in childhood, that is 14 years of age and younger. Second one, young adult. Age group is 15 to 34 years of age. The third one is older adult, 55 to 75 years of age. Hodgkin's disease usually presents with painless enlargement of one or more groups of lymph nodes. The affected lymph nodes may already be quite large when first noticed, and subsequent growth may often be negligible or the nodes may shrink or fluctuate in size. The enlarged lymph nodes are firm, non-tender and often feel rubbery. The neck and axillae are the sites most commonly involved at presentation. Occasionally, the disease is confined to the mediastinum, that is detected on routine chest radiograph. Presentations involving just infradiaphragmatic lymph nodes or extranodal sites are relatively uncommon. Waldeyer's ring, that is tonsils, adenoids and nasopharyngeal glands, is more likely to be involved in non-Hodgkin lymphomas. Splenomegaly may be present but does not always indicate involvement with Hodgkin's disease. Hepatomegaly is a feature of advanced disease. Bone involvement is rare, but may be suggested by local areas of pain and tenderness. Local skin infiltration sometimes occurs, particularly in the thoracic wall as an extension from mediastinal or hilar node involvement or in the region of massive lymph node enlargement. Extradural tumors occasionally produce cord compression in the spinal cord. Meningeal involvement occurs rarely. Both extradural tumors compressing the spinal cord and meningeal involvement are usually late features. Involvement of the kidneys is uncommon, but lymph node enlargement may cause an obstructive uropathy or occlude the renal vein, producing a nephrotic syndrome. Other rare features are involvement of the pericardium and the gastrointestinal tract. Systemic symptoms. Fever, drenching night sweats and weight loss are especially significant and indicate a worse prognosis. Fever may occasionally show a clear cyclical variation, alternating several days of fever with longer febrile periods. This is known as Pell-Epstein fever. It is considered to be characteristic of Hodgkin's disease, but it is rarely encountered in practice. Severe skin itching in some cases and may precede the onset of other features. It may be so generalized and intolerable that it leads to a widespread excoriation. It's usually relieved by treatment of the underlying condition. Alcohol-induced pain in affected sites is a dramatic but rare feature. On occasions, it may precede other manifestations of the disease at presentation or indicate early relapse. Pathological features. the classical histological appearance of lymph nodes affected by Hodgkin's disease is a replacement of the nodal architecture by a proliferation of abnormal mononuclear cells and the diagnostic Reed-Steinberg binucleate or multinucleate cells together with reactive cells. Four histological subtypes of Hodgkin's disease are generally recognized. The first histological type is nodular sclerosing. This accounts for about 40% of all Hodgkin's disease and for 70% of all the Hodgkin's cases in adolescents. This is the only form of Hodgkin's that is more prevalent in women. It can involve the lower cervical lymph nodes. The lymph node has a striking nodular appearance due to bands of collagenous connective tissue. The Hodgkin's mononuclear cells appear particularly well hydrated and the cytoplasm shrinks away from the peripheral attachments during processing to leave lacunae. Reed-Steinberg cells are usually easily found and there are variable proportions of lymphocytes, histiocytes, granulocytes, including eosinophils and plasma cells within the tumor nodules. Next histological type is mixed cellularity. This represents about 30% of Hodgkin's disease and usually affects children less than 10 years of age. This condition is usually an advanced disease. The architecture of the lymph node is diffusely effaced by a mixed infiltrate with conspicuous granulocytes, especially eosinophils, plasma cells, lymphocytes and histiocytes, and plentiful Reed-Steinberg cells. The next subtype is lymphocyte predominance. This accounts for 10% to 15% of Hodgkin's disease and is predominant in males and younger patients. The condition usually is localized and has the best likelihood of a good outcome. The infiltrate consists mainly of small lymphocytes with a variable admixture of histiocytes but very few granulocytes or plasma cells and infrequent Reed-Steinberg cells. There are two types, nodular and diffuse. Lymphocyte depleted. This condition is rare in children and more common in HIV-positive adults. It is usually a widespread disease. This is characterized by large numbers of atypical mononuclear cells, often pleomorphic with bizarre mitosis, and many Reed-Steinberg cells but a paucity of other cells. Often there is accompanying diffuse fibrosis. Thank you for listening. See you in the next class.